Big Pie in the Sky is a pig out destination for students and locals craving huge offerings of New York style thin crust pizza. From basic cheese to the big kahuna, everything is enormous.
This is like a Warhol. You could reproduce this one.
At most pizza joints, large is 16 inches. Here, that's the smallest size you can get. The 30-inch large needs to be put into perspective to be understood.
Compare the size of the beautiful child to the gigantic slice of pizza. I have to try to eat at least four of these, covered in every meat in the kingdom.
Owners Dirk Tendick and Chris Day started offering these slices bigger than your head in 2007. They introduced the Carnivore Challenge soon after.
All right, this stuff is the thing of legend. Tell me the legend.
Been attempted by many, finished by none at this point.
That's like a rap lyric.
Yeah.
Making the Carnivore isn't much easier than eating it. Everything is more complicated when you're dealing with a 30-inch pie.
You want to see how happy I am that I have a pizza challenge?
Pizza man Louis Foget guides me through the delicate process of preparing the dough.
So yeah, so you just slap like this.
Uh-huh.
Just rotate.
It's very kung fu, I like that.
Right.
So I'm gonna sit there and stretch till I feel the right moment. Hwah! Sort of.
After a healthy ladling of fresh tomato sauce.
It's really beautiful and vaguely hypnotic. Especially that spiral. I feel like I'm in the Manchurian Candidate.
Sprinklings of Parmesan, Romano, basil, oregano.
Awesome.
And three two-fisted handfuls of quality whole milk mozzarella. The six-pound pizza is ready for 5 pounds of meat. I stack on the pepperoni, sausage, beef.
Frosting a giant meat-filled cake. I'm loving it.
Bacon and ham. With the last cube of pork, my challenger is ready to weigh in.
We have 11 pounds of raw pizza punching power from Kennesaw, Georgia. In this corner, the challenger, the Carnivore.
The Carnivore goes into the oven, and I meet the man who's joining me in the trenches.
This is my partner. This is Drew Middlebrooks. He's faced the Carnivore, lived to tell the tale. Now, how far did you get?
When I did the challenge, I had eaten three slices, and I was on my fourth one, and my partner gave up.
Listen to me. Your partner may have quit on you, but that's not the kind of guy I am. I'd leave the chopper, and I'd come back, and I'd get you. I'd carry you 30 yards of pepperoni flying everywhere. Are we gonna do this today?
We're gonna do it.
Attention, please. This is the Carnivore Challenge, 11 pounds of pizza. Over 400 people have attempted this, and no one has finished it. These two guys have an hour to do it. Time starts when they begin eating. Have at it, guys.
We're gonna take each slice on our half, each four, stack them up into one giant lasagna layered slice. Let's put them together.
This is our first bite, everybody!
My first bite into the Carnivore is full of flavor. The basil in the sauce, the spices in the pepperoni, the milkiness of the mozzarella. I feel confident that Drew and I can take down this beast.
Be aggressive! Be aggressive!
This is history in the making!
Go big or go home at this point.
Yeah, you know what? I can agree
totally
more about
agree.
That.
Oh,
I
think
more about
do
that.
It.
Yeah.
Drew, you gotta step up. Come on, Drew.
Yeah.
Go, Drew.
Yeah.
Holy shit, Mookies. All right.
It's been 15 minutes, everybody. Let's hear it.
At the 15-minute mark, all I have left is four tiers of crust and assorted scraps of tomato, cheese, and meat. Before I can close it out, nature makes its call.
Hey, Derek, what's the rule on peeing?
You can if you need to.
I can pee.
As long as you don't lose anything in the bathroom, you're good. Keep it down, everybody. We gotta hear it.
All right, ready?
Everything sounds good.
Legit, legit, legit. I'm coming correct with it. Let me go help Drew out.
My half of the Carnivore is nearing its demise. But my partner Drew's plate looks a lot more menacing.
Drew, this isn't boy versus food. This is man versus food. Man up!
This is brutal.
Don't eat 5.5 pounds of pizza. That's a life lesson from your Uncle Adam.
We're about halfway through time, 28 minutes. This is definitely one of the best challenges I've seen this far. Adam is doing fantastic, and Drew Buddy's not far behind him. So I think they're both doing very well.
Everybody, it's been a half hour. They're halfway through.
Come on, Drew, you can do it, buddy.
Come on, guys.
Dude,
come
you
on.
Do it. Power
come
through.
On.
Mind doesn't matter, just
go.
Ain't no shame in the, you know, what we've done.
I'm almost to the crust, about to finish my half of the carnivore, but Drew looks pale.
I got the meat sweats going, I'm done.
I think I'm getting a little pizza drunk.
I am wasted on pizza.
Yeah, dude.
Completely wasted. I gotta go hang out with the wall now.
Drew is gone, so I'm gonna spit out some marinara for my homie who ain't here no more.
Clear the way, clear the way.
Adam, stop eating. I've been informed that the pizza has exited Drew. At 44 minutes, the competition is over.
I don't want anyone slagging off on my friend. He put in a great effort. Let's everyone give it up for my partner, Drew, and his valiant effort. Today, in Kennesaw, Georgia, two warriors entered the realm of combat against a beast known only as the carnivore. I left it all on the battlefield, as did my partner. He also left some behind the building.
Sad, but true.